Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, and if you're new, what's up, what's good with you? Thank you so much for being here. My name is Shani, and my lash is sticking to my bottom lash. Cute! So in today's video, I'm going to be showing you guys how I got this makeup look right here. This is the last video of 2018, and y'all, 2018, girl, this year was a lot. It was a lot, but your girl made it through. We made it through. Thank you guys so much for the support throughout 2018. It was filled with a whole bunch of ups and downs, you know, a whole bunch. Okay, let's just say that. So of course your girl has to end off the year with a banger, and I've decided to go with a more traditional classic makeup look. So here it is. I really love how it came out. I tried out a new eyeshadow technique, which y'all will see in the video. Hopefully it's not too much for you guys to grasp, but honestly it's really, really easy. So I really hope you guys enjoy the look, and let's just go ahead and get right into it. Okay, so I already did my eyebrows and primed my eyelids off camera. I did my eyebrows with the Anastasia Dip Brow in Ebony, and then I primed my eyelids with the LA Girl Pro Concealer in Chestnut and mixed it with the Too Faced Concealer in Chestnut. I was trying to only work out of one palette for this eye look, but honestly I couldn't find mauve shades that I was looking for, so I'm just going to hop and skip through a whole bunch of palettes that I have, and hopefully you guys don't mind. Okay, sorry, my bad. I'm going to be using a different technique when it comes to doing my eyeshadow today, and hopefully it comes out good. I haven't worked with these eyeshadows from Pure when it comes to using this technique. I've only used some of my MAC eyeshadows, but anyway, the technique that I'm talking about, I got it from Amanda Dizzle on Instagram. And if you guys do not know about Amanda, listen, y'all need to go follow her right now. When I seen how she did eye makeup, she goes right into doing, you know, the eyeshadow on the eyelids, and then she does like the transition, and then she deepens it. I just like the way she did the eye makeup, and it came out so freaking beautiful. She did it on her best friend, if I'm not mistaken. Ever since I've seen her technique when it comes to doing eyeshadow, I was just amazed, because I never thought about doing that before. So like I said, I'm going to be going right in and doing my mobile eyelid color. So I'm going to be taking this color right here from this Pure palette. It's called Snake Eyes, and this is an individual eyeshadow from Pure. This came from the Creator palette, which it's housed in, and that's the color. Can y'all see that? That's the color right there. It's like a mauve-y, pinky silver shade, and it's really reflective, so I'm gonna be using that. I was gonna use She Sparkles, but I used that last year in my prom tutorial, or was it 2 years ago? I don't know. I used it a while ago and I didn't want to use it again because I didn't really like how white it was looking. So we're going to be using Snake Eyes, and I'm just going to press this all over my mobile eyelid, and I'm using a Sigma E25 brush. So that's that. Now I'm going to take my Morphe M532 brush from Morphe, and I'm taking this blush from Coastal Scents, and this is going to be my transition color. Now when I was thinking about doing this look, I wanted more of a mauve shade, but I couldn't find no mauve shade in my collection. I was just like, yo, how do I not have a mauve pinky cool tone color? So I'm just taking this color and blending it all throughout my transition area. Now I'm going into my Warm's Neutral palette from MAC, and I'm taking this color right here, which is Dance in the Dark. And I'm just going to press this into the outer corner of my eye and blend it inward. There's so much fallout. Gosh. Now I'm taking Corrupt from Makeup Geek to deepen this corner even more. I just love how everything just looks whoosh, like really nice and together, you know? That's what I like about her technique. minus all this fallout I got going on. See, this is why I don't like fallout. Because I take my time and moisturize my face and all that good stuff, and then after I'm done with my eyes, I gotta go back and wipe all of that off. My skincare costs money. So I'm gonna need for it to stay and soak in my skin, not wipe it off. Is my exposure okay? Can y'all see me? Just forget that I used the Coastal Scents blush. Yeah, just erase that from your memory. I used Desirose because that's basically what y'all are seeing as my transition. Why do I keep putting the brushes back that I'm using? I'm still using you. 514, going back in with Dance in the Dark just to make sure everything is blended. This eye is definitely different than this eye. So annoying. Okay. Now I'm going to do liner, and I'm going to attempt to do this on camera. I'm taking this no-named clay paint liner. It has a name, but they've been canceled, so I ain't saying the name on here. Not on my channel. No, we not. So, taking that liner, and I'm using a MAC 210 brush to do this liner. Y'all know I'm about to smoke it out, so let's get into it. Actually, let me scoot up. Wow. Probably should have been this close from the beginning, but it's okay. Y'all, I need to be closer for this, and if I get closer, I'm gonna be out of the frame. Ooh. I'm so far away. This part takes concentration, okay? Y'all, I gotta do this part off camera, okay? I'll try it. Okay, so boom, liner is on. Now we're gonna go ahead and smoke it out with the eyeshadow in Corrupt from Makeup Geek. And we're just going to pat the black eyeshadow on the edge of the eyeliner and then just tap it upwards. And that is the start of blending out the liner. If y'all see glitter all throughout my hair and my brows, I'm gonna have glitter on me probably for the rest of the year because I dropped my glitter pigment. Now, I don't know if y'all know, but when it comes to glitter, if you drop it, it legit gets everywhere. So it's on my eyeshadow palettes, it's on the floor, it's on my desk, it's in my brushes, it's everywhere. So I'm pretty sure I'm probably gonna have glitter on me for a lot of months, okay? So, if y'all see glitter, just ignore it. I try to like clean all my eyeshadow palettes off and the floor off, but it's still on the floor. Like I have some on my bed. It's on my freaking head. It's on my headboard, y'all. Like how did it get on my headboard? How? Let's move on to adding a little bit of glitter. Even though I just said glitter is literally everywhere, I want to add more glitter to my eyes because it's the new year, and what is a new year makeup look without glitter? It's not a new year's makeup look if you don't have glitter on your face. I'm sorry. I'm gonna take my NYX glitter adhesive, glitter primer, put it on the back of my hand, like so, right there. And I'm gonna take this dual fiber blend brush from Sigma. This is the E41, and I'm just going to pick up that product and pat it sporadically. Is that the word that I'm trying to use? Stipple. I'm just gonna stipple it over this eyeshadow we got going on. I feel like I'm not centered, but you know what? When am I ever centered when it comes to these videos? Let it dry a little bit and get tacky. Try not to blink. We don't need no creases. Taking my glitter, I'm gonna tell y'all the name when I'm done with this, but it's from MAC. And it's silver. And I'm working off the top. And I'm just gonna press this. Oh crap, that's too much. I'm just gonna press this all over and hopefully it sticks. This is such a weird angle. I want the glitter to look scattered. I don't want it to look like it's in one place, you know? We're gonna be doing the Dragon Lee lashes, which I wasn't trying to do because they are on the dramatic and long side. I just wanted a little drama. These are just like dramatic. I'm just measuring them, y'all, to see how they look. I'm not putting them all in right now. Do these? Yes, I do. So I'm gonna go ahead and put these on for real off camera, wipe off my face and all this glitter, prime it again, and I will be back to do my face makeup. Okay, all right, like I said, I have to re-moisturize my face because I wiped everything off. So I'm moisturizing with the Dramatically Different moisturizing lotion from Clinique. All right, skin is moisturized. Now I'm gonna go ahead and prime. And to prime, I've been using this Caudalie Blemish Control Infusion Serum. I'm using that to prime my face and I really feel like it fills in my pores and mattifies me a little bit as well. So I've been using it right here in my T-zone. And it says to avoid the under eye area, so I just brush it down and up to avoid that area. That's gonna be my primer slash skincare for today. It's not really a primer. I don't think it's a primer. It makes my face feel like it's tightening in a good way, and I really, really love the smell. And I love their little mist that I ran out of. For foundation, I'm going to be using, I forgot to put my sponge. I'm like getting up. Why do I always do this? I got my sponge, but before I move on to the face, I'm just gonna go ahead and line my bottom waterline with this black gel before it dries up. All right, bottom lash line is lined. Now I'm gonna go ahead and color correct with the NARS foundation in New Caledonia D2. I'm using the Fenty Beauty sponge because my other sponges are kind of dirty. This was the only clean one, so we're using her. Dab, dab, dab. For foundation, I was gonna use the NYX foundation, but I don't know where I put that. So, I'm just gonna be using the Born This Way foundation in Cocoa. Now to highlight, I'm taking the Born This Way concealer in Chestnut. Oh my gosh, I'm so rude. How was everybody's Christmas? What did y'all do? What did y'all get? Even though Christmas isn't about the gifts, honestly. This year, I didn't even buy anybody any gift. Except for my best friend, because we already said we were gonna get each other gifts and she told me what she wanted, so that's besides the point. But yeah, I didn't buy anybody any gifts this year. One, because I'm trying to save money and pay off credit cards. Two, we just gonna leave it at one. I really didn't want anything, didn't really care to get anything this year. And I feel like I'm that way every year, and when it comes to my birthday as well, I don't care. I care, but then again, I don't care. I would rather buy myself what I want. It's kind of hard for me to tell people what I want because I'm going to end up buying it myself. But yeah, Christmas was good. I was just there for the food. I hope you guys' Christmas was good as well. And if you didn't get what you wanted, buy it yourself. That's it. And if you can't buy it yourself, save up for it, okay? Now I'm just gonna go ahead and set my under eyes with the Sasha Buttercup setting powder. I'm gonna go ahead and set the rest of my face. Laugh lines, definitely gotta set those. Okay, so today I'm gonna be using the Studio Fix powder in NC47 because I cannot find my Sephora powder that y'all know I normally use, but I'm just gonna use Studio Fix today, it's all good. Y'all, I've been trying to film all day. Usually I'm just like, yeah, I'm about to film this, this, that, and the third. And today it was just like, I don't feel like doing this, for better words. It's not that I didn't feel like doing it. I was just tired the whole entire day. I woke up tired. Now it's time to contour with the Fenty Beauty Matchstick in Espresso. You'll already know. And we're just gonna go ahead and bronze it up. Now I'm just gonna go back into my Warm's Neutral palette, taking this color right here on my Morphe E36 brush, and we're just smoking out this bottom lash line. Yo, why do I feel like, bruh, I feel like I'm getting sick. I don't got time to be sick, so I'm gonna need this to go away. Tie my inner corner. I'm taking this color right here from the Anastasia Sun Dipped Glow Kit. This is like a cool tone color. And then I'm taking that on my brow bone. And then I just took the bronzy color mixed with the cool tone color and highlighted my face. All right, you guys, so this is the finished makeup look. I really hope you guys liked it. If you did, go ahead and give me a thumbs up, comment down below, and also subscribe to the channel if you have not already. If you went the whole 2018 without subscribing to my channel and you are still here, there is a problem. Just go ahead and subscribe to my channel. Like, what are you doing? No, but for real, thank you guys so much for the love and support throughout 2018. 2019 is going to be an amazing year. Lash is still trying to stick. What's good with you? So yeah, I might want to get ready. Your girl might just pop off in 2019. So yeah, I really hope you guys like this look. I love y'all. Thank y'all so much for the love and support. Be safe, enjoy yourself, have a happy and blessed new year, and I will see you guys in my next video, which will be in the new year. Bye. Oh, I almost forgot. Just subscribe right here and watch the next video. I had to.